Hello, my dear student friends, welcome you all to the Digital Image Processing video lecture series. In this video lecture, we shall be discussing about chapter number 2. So, in this video lecture, we are starting with the chapter number 2. The name of this chapter is nothing but the image transformation. Okay, so remember that in this chapter, we shall be discussing about different gray level image transformation methods on the different images. Okay. So ultimately we are going to have some practical sessions over this as well. Okay, so while discussing our different methodologies of transformation, we shall be taking simple programs. Based on that, we are going to check out how the image is going to get transformed after performing that operation. Okay, so let us discuss some gray level transformation in this video lecture. Okay, so this is nothing but a gray level transformation. Okay, so image enhancement simply means that we are going to perform some kind of transformation on particular image whenever we are going to take that image, and definitely we used to go for the different kinds of transformation. Let us say it may be a black and white transformation, it may be a gray level transformation, different again combinations of gray level intensities and all these things that we used to go for the transformation once we click the image, right? So once we used to take the selfie, we used to go for the different transformations, right? Okay, so over here as well, we are going to discuss the same kind of technique. Okay, so the transformation of an image F, let us say F is an image and we have G is an output image, which is nothing but a transformed image from that particular F image. Okay, so we can say that F is an our input image and finally we will be getting output image as G. Is that fine? And definitely the T is nothing but a transformation that we are going to perform on that particular image, right? So here is nothing but, what is T? T is nothing but your transformation method. What kind of transformation we are going to perform on that particular input image, that we are going to discuss in the further upcoming slides, right? Okay, the values of pixels in images, let us say F and R, G, are denoted by R and S. Okay, so remember that pixel values, that means the gray level intensities of the different pixels, are represented or denoted by R and S respectively for particular F image and G image. Are you getting it? So over here, so as it said, the pixel values R and S are represented by an expression of T is equals to a transformation based on that particular gray level intensities of your F image, right? So gray level intensities of F image is nothing but R, and gray level intensities of your new G image is nothing but what? S. Okay, I hope you are getting the correlation between the S and R, right, with respect to that F and G. Okay, and T is nothing but the type of transformation that we have used. Okay, so where T is a transformation that maps pixel values R into pixel values of S. Okay, so it is again a mapping function in between the, let us say, R pixel and S pixel. Is that fine? Okay, so let us discuss what are the different types of transformation that we are going to understand in this gray level intensity transformation. Okay, so enhanced images provide better contrast details than that of the original images. So why we usually go for the transformation? Actually, the need of transformation is to get the more detailed information or get more clarity of that particular image, that whatever we have taken the image. So it is nothing but a simply enhancement, image enhancement technique, right? So once we use to capture the image, we go for the enhancement of the image, right? So in the first chapter, what we discuss, how to take the image and what are the basic fundamental steps are there to capture the images, and then how we are going to convert that physical quantity, that is nothing but the scene, whatever it may be, how to convert that scene into the digital quantity and all these things that we have seen. And then we have seen the different basic correlation between the pixels, what are the relationship between the pixels and all these things that we have discussed in the previous lecture, right? Okay, fine. So in this case, now as we have taken the images, now we need to go for the image enhancement. So I hope you still remember the basic fundamental block diagram of your digital image processing, right? So in that case, we have discussed that is nothing but the fundamental steps involved in the DIP, right? So first step is what? You have to acquire the image. So once you are going to acquire the image, So whatever we have discussed in the very first chapter, that is nothing but the simply acquiring the image, right? And now what we are going to go for, the next step after acquisition, image acquisition, is what? You have to go for the image enhancement, right? So right now we are studying different types of image enhancement techniques in a gray level images. Okay, so in a gray level images, we are going to understand different types of image enhancement techniques. Are you getting it? Fine. So remember that enhanced images provide, so by means of transformation, we are going to provide some kind of enhancement into the images, right? So remember that after providing this kind of image enhancement, better contrast details can be obtained as compared to your original images, right? So by means of image enhancement, we are going to get more detailed information related to the contrast, right? For example, a medical image is there, a medical image analysis or status satellite images are there. In that case, very low levels of contrast is there, and by means of transformation we can get a better quality of contrast, and because of that we can predict something that yes, there is some problem related to the medical issue and all these things, or the satellite issues we can identify by means of performing some enhancement techniques, right? Okay, so there are three basic types of transformation functions that we are going to use in case of image enhancement, right? So one is nothing but a linear, then another one is nothing but a logarithmic. Okay, so linear, logarithmic, then power law transformation. So these are the three different basic transformation methods that we are going to use in case of our image transformation, right? Okay, so over here, as you can see, this is nothing but the image related to, or the, this is the figure which is going to illustrate what kind of transformation that we are going to use. Okay, so let us discuss one by one. Okay, so in linear, let us say in linear, identity and the negation, image negation and identity, these are the two types of transformation that we are going to perform in case of linear transformation, right? In case of logarithmic transformation, so definitely as there is a log function is associated with that, so definitely we are going to perform some logarithmic operation onto that particular, let us say, images, okay? And based on that logarithmic function, we are going to find out some values related to the output, okay? So input images, image pixel values will have a logarithmic function, okay? So we are going to perform the logarithmic operation on that particular pixel intensities, and we are going to get some values of that particular logarithmic function, right? Okay, so that is nothing but your logarithmic kind of operation. And then next one is nothing but a power law. So as you can say that it is nothing but a power, that is nothing but definitely a rest to the power, okay? So power law transformation is definitely using a rest to power, and based on that we can perform different kind of, again, transformation methods, right? Okay. So as you can notice over here, identity and negative curves fall under the category of linear functions. So identity, I hope it is visible to you, right? So this is nothing but your identity curve. That means whatever the pixel information, it is there into the your original image, it will be same reflected over here. So that is the meaning of that identity. Identity means the input image and output image will be same as that of your original image, right? So input image will be your original image, and output image is also your original image, okay? That is no transformation, that means no changes into the pixel levels or pixel values we are going to perform, right? Okay, then the image negation. What do you mean by negation? As the name itself indicates that we are going to take the negative image, right? I hope you might have seen the negative films, right? So black and white films were there, okay, in olden days, whenever there were camera rolls, right? So those kind of images are nothing but called as a negative images, right? So over here also we are going to perform image negation so that we can identify very important aspects of your particular images, right? So image negation is mostly used in case of let us say x-rays and medical field, right? So image negation transformation is a very important transformation used in case of your image, medical image processing, right? Okay. So that means what? If the zero intensity level is there, simply we are going to negate it. So I hope you studied about NOT gate, right? So what is the function of NOT gate? Whatever there let us say 0 is in applied as an input to this NOT gate, what will be the output? Output will be 1, right? And if 1 is input, output will be 0, right? So it is converting exactly opposite to that particular value, right? So over here also 0 is, let us say, input pixel value, then output pixel value will be what? L minus 1. Let us say L is nothing but 8. Okay, so 8 minus 1 is nothing but 7. So 7th level of gray level information will be, it will be representing for 0th level. Okay, so if original image is having a 0 as a pixel information, then it is going to represent it as 8, as 7 as a output pixel information, right? Okay, so likewise we are going to go for image negation, right? So right now this is nothing but identity, and exactly opposite of this, this is nothing but a negation. Okay, so it's opposite, right? So whatever the information is available, convert it into a higher end. Let us say dark pixel is there, it will be converted into bright pixel, right? So like that you are going to perform operation based on that image negation, right? And then log and inverse log curves fall under the category of logarithmic function. Okay, so log over here, log is not mentioned over here right now. It is not, yes it is there. Okay, so log is nothing but over here. Yes, it is over here. So logarithmic function is nothing but having some, again, log operation we are going to perform, right? Okay, so based on that, this is the curve representing to the log, and anti-log, that is nothing but inverse log, we are going to perform in this manner, right? So likewise the curves are representing. And then nth power, let us say nth power, this is nothing but the power law transformation, right? So this is nothing but a power law transformation, okay, and this is nothing but a nth power law transformation. Is that fine? Okay, is it visible? Let me zoom it. Okay, it is nth root, right? It is nth root, and this is nothing but the nth power. Okay, so rest to half, let us say rest to half and rest to power 2. Okay, so nth root is nothing but, let us say, rest to half, right? Root is nothing but definitely rest to 1 by some value. Okay, it, if it is a square root, then definitely it will be 1 by 2, rest to 1 by 2. If it is a square cube root, then it will be 1 by third. Okay, rest to 1 by third. And this is nothing but nth power. Okay, so nth power is nothing but, let us say, 10 raised to 2, 10 raised to 3, 10 raised to 4, likewise. This is nothing but nth power. Are you getting it? Fine. Okay. Then the log and inverse log curves fall under the category of logarithmic functions, and nth root and the nth power transformation fall under the category of power law transformation. Is that fine? Okay. So let us discuss something about it. Suppose there is an image, right? Suppose there is an image, let us say we have this image. Okay, fine. Let us say gray level intensities, L is nothing but, let us say, 8. Okay, and then L minus 1 will be what? It will be 7, isn't it? So let us say 0, 1, 2, again let us say 2, 3, 4, 5, then 7 and 0. Okay, so let us say this is nothing but our F image. Okay, let us say this is our F image. Okay, so image, input image, let us say, right? And we have studied different transformations. So which are the transformation? First is our linear transformation, right? In linear transformation there are again two parts. One is identity, right? And second one is what? It's negation. Okay, identity means what? So what is our G image? G is, it is a transformation on, transformation of F, right? Okay, so identity will have, there is no transformation, that means it will be as it is. So G is equals to F, right? So that means this will be G also for identity type of transformation. Okay, identity, is that fine? Okay, so G is equals to F in case of identity, because there is no change into the input image and output image, right? But in case of, let us say, in case of image negation, what is the image negation? Let us understand now. Okay, so let us understand image negation. Okay, what is image negation? So image negation is nothing but, it will be represented as, your S is represented as L minus 1 minus R. Okay, let us assume that these are nothing but all the gray level intensities, right? Okay, so remember that these are nothing but, R is corresponding to the gray level intensities of your F image, right? And S is nothing but your gray level intensities of your G image, that is output image, right? Okay, so what is L? L is nothing but 8, 8 minus 1 is 7, and corresponding values of R, right? So let us say, right now we are finding out, okay, let us say right now we are finding out the value of this for image negation. Okay, so what will be the value? 7 minus 0. What is the answer? Yes, it is 7. Okay, so 0 is replaced by 7. Okay, so in case of your image negation, let us say your G image is nothing but this one. Okay, so image G will be having 7 as the value for this corresponding 0. Are you getting it? So this 0 is represented as 7 in case of image negation. So I hope we have tackled it, right? So black pixel has been converted into white pixel, right? Okay, similarly let us go for this one, for this. Now 7 minus 1, what will be the answer? 7 minus 1 will be 6, isn't it? So over here it will be 6, right? Then 7 minus 2 for this one. For this one, 7 minus 2 will be there, right? So 7 minus 2 will be what? It is, it will be 5, right? This is also 5. Then 7 minus 3 will be 4. 7 minus 4 will be 3. Are you getting it? So 7 minus 5 will be 2. 7 minus 7 will be 0, right? So 7 is represented as 0 over here, isn't it? Okay, and 7 minus 0 will be also represented as 7, right? So this is nothing but your image negation of this particular image, right? So this image we have converted into image negation, right? Okay, I hope with the simple example you might have understood what is exactly, what is identity and that is nothing but linear transformation methods, right? Identity and image negation, right? Okay, so let us discuss image negation first. Fine. So negative of an image with the gray levels, now I hope you can understand easily with this basic example, right? So the negative of an image with the gray levels in the range, let us say L minus 1, 0 to L minus 1, okay? So we have considered L as 8, right? So L minus 1 will be 7. So range of the gray level intensities will be what? 0 to 7, right? Is obtained by the negative transformation shown in figure above, which is given by, so what is the expression of your image negation? It is S is equals to L minus 1 minus R, right? So R is nothing but your original image pixel value or gray level value, okay? And L minus 1 is nothing but a gray level intensities ranging from 0 to L minus 1, right? So L minus 1 is nothing but a range of gray level intensities, right? Okay. Then the expression results in a reversing of gray level intensities. I hope with the very simple example you understood how the gray levels are going to get reversed, right? Okay, of the image, thereby producing a negative like image. So this is going to create a negative type of image after performing of this image negation transformation, right? So I hope this is a very simple type of transformation, isn't it? So image in negative transformation, each value of an input image is subtracted from the L minus 1 and mapped onto the output image, right? So I hope over here. So all the pixels we have subtracted from this L minus 1, that is 7. Okay, so every pixel value we have subtracted from L minus 1, that is 7, and we have mapped out to that particular S level. Okay, so R, that is nothing but the gray level intensities of your original image have been mapped to the intensities of your new image, right? Okay, so that is nothing but S has been mapped to, that is R has been mapped to the S, right? Okay, this is particularly useful for enhancing white or gray details embedded in a dark regions of an image. So remember that this kind of image enhancement technique is used to enhance the white, that is nothing but the gray level details which are present into the dark regions of your image, right? So basically, in case of your medical kind of application, in that case definitely this image negation will help you to get the more details about your what we can call that the black details are there and that has been converted into white, right? Okay, so let us see how to convert that black and white the image into the image negation form. Okay, so this is nothing but the program to convert the image into the black and white, and then we are going to convert its image negation, right? So right now this is nothing but your color image, right? So this is nothing but your color image, fine. And this color image we have converted into gray level image, right? So I hope this is nothing but your gray level image, okay? And then we have gone for the gray level transformation. So what is the program? Program is nothing but close all, clear all. I hope you are aware about it, because you might have gone for the MATLAB, right? In your third year, or you might have gone for the Scilab. If there is not, you might not have used MATLAB, then you might have gone for the Scilab, right? Or you might have already gone for the Octave. If you don't know Octave, we are going to use Octave for our practical purpose, right? Octave is nothing but an open source software for your MATLAB. Okay, it is a equivalent to the MATLAB. Okay, so it is a open source software which is equivalent to the MATLAB software, right? Okay, so over here we don't have directly inbuilt functions or the libraries related to the image processing toolbox. Okay, so ultimately we need to load the image toolbox or image package into this Octave. So for that purpose, the package rebuild, we need to go for the rebuilding of the package, and then we need to go for the rebuilding or loading the package, image package. Okay, because we are going to use a different image related functions, right? So I am read, I am show, and all these things that are there into this image package. Okay, if you are not going to load this image package, we cannot we cannot use these functions. It will be giving you error that this function is not available, what is the meaning of this and all these things. Such kind of errors will be there, okay, if you are not going to load this image package, right? So for that purpose, pkg, and we are going to load that package of image into the Octave. Okay, so let us go for the Octave, fine. Okay, so this is nothing but my Octave software. Okay, so this is nothing but Octave, right? I have simply copied and pasted over here, and this program I have created over here, right? Fine. So remember that this is nothing but the path of image. Okay, so I have stored that image onto my D drive. Okay, and the name of that particular file is nothing but scene.jpg. So while mentioning your let us say path of image, you have to mention its path, then the file name and its extension, what type of file it is, that you also mention over here. Okay, so you need to mention the file extension name as well, right? If you don't mention the file extension, then again it will give you error, right? Okay, so remember that this is nothing but a pkg load image, right? So we have loaded the image package to use into the Octave, right? Okay, then the first function that we are going to use is nothing but ultimately we need to read the image, right? So there is a digital image we have stored onto our one of the drive, or the location may be anything. Okay, so you are going to give the path of that particular image along with the name, right? And that along with the file extension. So you are going to mention the file extension as well in a single inverted comma. If you are going to use a double inverted comma also, then there will be an error, right? Okay, so this is nothing but you by means of this IAM read. So IAM stands for image and read stands for reading of the image, and it is going to read that image and it will store into this. Okay, so A is nothing but an array, right? So array is nothing but what? This is the size of that array, right? So 810 multiplied by 810 and multiplied by 3. So it is a three dimensional array. Are you getting it? So three dimensional array means it is having rows, columns and three color information, that is RGB. Are you getting it? So 810 columns, 810 rows, sorry, rows, columns and three color information, that is RGB. Okay, 810 rows, 810 columns and three color information, that is RGB. Okay, so I hope this is nothing but your image is nothing but a RGB image, color image, right? Okay, and you just remember that it is nothing but unsigned integer 8. So it is a 8-bit integer, right? So what is the value of 8-bit integer? 8-bit integer is ranging from, unsigned integer is ranging from what? 0 to 255, right? Okay, so remember that each pixel is having a value as in between 0 to 255. Remember it, okay? Fine. If you can find out the values, lot of values will be there. Okay, so you can over identify over here. After converting that gray level in, information, that is RGB information into gray level, so these are nothing but the pixel information of the particular image. Okay, so likewise 810 columns and 810 pixels will be there. Okay, fine. So this is nothing but representing your first column, second column, likewise it is go on increasing, right? And then the number of pixels again. Okay, fine. So let us come back to the editor. So imread is the function which is going to read the image. Then subplot, I hope you know, you are aware about subplot, how the subplots works and all these things, but still let us discuss that subplot. Okay, now what is subplot? Subplot is nothing but dividing of your screen. Okay, so it is nothing but dividing your screen into different plots, right? So let us say this is our screen, right? And we are dividing that screen, subplot. What was the function? Subplot is the function, and inside that it will have row, then column and position, right? So this is the function actually. Okay, so first value is nothing but row, number of rows, number of columns and the position. Okay, so let us say I have defined as subplot 3, 3, 2. What is the meaning of this? How many number of rows? 3 rows. So first row, second row and third row, right? So this is nothing but your first row, this is nothing but your second row, this is nothing but your third row, right? Okay, so next is what? Three columns. So column number 1, column number 2 and column number 3, right? So this is nothing but your column, so column, and this is row. Okay, so row and column, right? Okay, so column number 1, column number 2 and column number 3. Okay, so what is the position of this right now? It is number 2. So remember that how many such brackets are there. So now how many slots will be created? 9 slots, 3 by 3, right? So 1 2 3 4 5 6, then 7 8, and finally 9, right? So what is the position of that particular slot? Subplot, we are going to plot it at this position. Are you getting it? Okay, so remember that whenever we are going to use subplot function, it is going to select position and row and column. Okay, if I am going to mention over here 3, 3, 5, so my image will be displayed at this position. Okay, if I am going to say subplot 3, 3, 9, then my image will be displayed at this position. Is that fine? So remember this thing. Okay, wait a minute. Yes, okay, so this is nothing but subplot. Now over here I am going to use single row, single column, sorry, number of three columns and the first image will be displayed at position number one, right? Then I'm going to show this image, that is nothing but a color image I'm going to show at the position one, okay? And the name of that image is nothing but I have given as original image. Then the function, that is RGB to gray of A. So A is my original image, that is nothing but a color image, right? And that color image I am going to convert into grayscale information, right? And the converted pixel information will be stored at B, okay? So this is the meaning of this particular sentence or line of this program, okay? So we are going to perform RGB to gray, okay? So we are converting the RGB image, that is color image, to gray level information. And what is the color image? That is nothing but containing into which attribute? That is nothing but A. So A is a variable which is holding the A image, that is color image, right? And this we are going to convert into gray by means of this RGB to gray function, okay? And the converted image will be stored at B, okay? So B variable will be holding now our grayscale information or gray image, right? And that image we are going to show, that is by using imshow function, image show function, okay? And the name of that, the title for that particular image is nothing but gray image. Is that fine? Finally, we are going to go for image negation, okay? So how to perform image negation? Right now, it is unit unsigned integer 8 bit, right? Unsigned integer 8. Yes, it is unsigned 8 now. So what will be the maximum size? What is L? L will be 256, right? So L minus 1 must be over here, right? So L minus 1 is what? 256 minus 1 will be 255, okay? And B is now my black and white image or gray level image, right? Sorry, not a black and white, it is a gray level image. And that gray level image I am using over here. So those particular gray level intensities will be subtracted from 255 intensity, okay? And that value or that image is going to get stored into the C, okay? So C is having another type of image which is holding the image negated image, right? Okay, so image negation information will be stored at C variable, okay? And that variable, that is nothing but that image we are going to show by means of a function imshow, okay, C. And that is nothing but a negative image. I hope this program you understood it very well. Yes, okay, so let us run this program. So once I click on run, it will show. Okay, so this is nothing but our original image, right? I have taken any random image, right? So this is nothing but my color image, and that color image we have converted into gray level image by using function RGB to gray. And finally, that gray image we have converted into after converting that gray level information into the negative image, right? So wherever there was a black image information, that has been converted into white information, right? And wherever there was a white image, okay, so that has been converted into, let us say over here, white was there and now it has been converted to black, right? So it is simply we have converted that image negation, right? So negative image we have created by means of this program, okay? Is this fine? I hope you understood it very well, okay? Same program and same image output I have taken over here in order to illustrate this image negation over here, right? Okay, fine, next.